Good afternoon, everybody. This could be an outstanding competition.
Good afternoon, ladies
The standard,
and gentlemen.
I've been told on arriving here, was absolutely
loud.
Phenomenal. Not even
fast.
The experts, as you heard there from Lee, can pick a winner. We have six of the 10 fastest teams in Europe. The first ever non-UK team to come here, and they are very, very heavily fancied to go a long way. The Road Runners from Belgium, and people are saying confidently the Crufts record could go at any time. That record is 15.20 seconds, just 15 seconds to get four dogs up and down that course. And the popularity of flyball unrivaled. The arena has filled almost to its 7,000 capacity very, very quickly indeed. A real buzz, a real sense of anticipation. The teams coming out here are Wendell Drifters from Wellingborough in Northampton. They will be on the near side, which is the blue obstacles. And High Flyers, Lincolnshire, Bedfordshire and Northampton, they will be on the far side in the red. Quarterfinals then, Moulton Magnets against Southern Striders, All for One against Commandos, and Roadrunners Beep Beep from Belgium against Commandos Allied Forces. And four will go through and four will go home. Basically, we'll have Thursday champions, and then we will have Friday champions tomorrow, four from losing four each day on Saturday, right the way through to the final on Sunday. Let's have a word from Graham Partridge. This is going to be a practice run, by the way. And it will not count. They're just going to get a practice run. On you go, Graham.
Yep. This will be the first round, and everybody will get a practice run. And this is really just so that the dogs can actually see the boxes, get used to the atmosphere, because week in, week out, they're not used to competing with an arena commentator. They're not used to the lights, the TV cameras and everything else. So this allows them to settle down. They will not get a second practice run. So this is it. So they just need to make sure that they're prepared as they possibly can be. It also gives them a chance to see that the dogs are performing as they want them to be. It may well be that a dog's having a bit of an off day or something like that, or can't catch the ball as they want it to. So they'll just see and they'll fine-tune the last team that they're going to run.
We've seen shots there of a Jenny Knight, the flyball judge, and they are just having a little loose there here, a little practice, if you like. On the near side, the blue Wendell Drifters quartet. It'll be JJ, Mika, Seb and Amber, the first four dogs, against the High Flyers on the far side, the red. Orson, Edge, Cupid and Potter, border collies, all those four. Best of three then. And as we've been saying, just to taste the atmosphere as they're building up and hyping up those dogs. And do not blink. Do not go away, because this is really, really rapid. Doing a little spot of practice on that far side before the real thing starts.
And as you can see, the High Flyers just having a little bit of trouble with one or two of their dogs. They're just taking a minute to settle, but I think the judge has decided that we're almost ready to start racing.
That's Jenny Knight, who competes with her flyball team in Cambridgeshire. So, on the near side, the blue side, Wendell Drifters, Wellingborough in Northamptonshire, the High Flyers from Lincolnshire, Bedfordshire and Northants, best of three. They are on the far side, the red side. JJ, Mika, Seven, Amber for Wendell. Orson, Edge, Cupid and Potter for the Flyers. We're set, we're ready. Fly ball at Crufts 2022 is underway. Near side have it at the moment. Wendell Drifters, just with Wendell Drifters, but very, very little in it. Very close, making ground on the High Flyers. It's with the High Flyers on the far side, the red side. The High Flyers are going to take this first one, barring anything unfortunate. The High Flyers by some distance. It is the High Flyers on that far side that take the first heat and go one up. Very, very confident. Orson, Edge, Cubitt and Potter Wendell Drifters, to remind you then, they have to pull this one round. 8 years that team has been established, otherwise it's a quick exit from Croft 2022. High Flyers on that far side, on the red course, 1-2 the good. High Flyers also made Cubitt and Potter starting that quartet, starting in great form. Jenny Knight, are we ready? We are indeed. Heat two. Away they go. Good start by JJ for Wendell on this near side. And the Drifters have it just at the moment. The Flyers making up ground with that second dog. And it's the Flyers again with the third dog on that far side. Great stuff. And will it be Potter to take the Flyers home on the far side? I think it will be, you know. I think the Flyers are off and running. It's going to be the Flyers. Yep, through they go. Confirmation from Jenny Knight. The first to go through. The High Flyers from Lincolnshire, the current European multi-breed record holders. Very impressive, Graham.
It was, and if you've never seen fly ball, that's what it's all about. It is fast, furious, and above all, it's fun. These dogs absolutely love to race, and it also makes great entertainment for this packed out capacity crowd here at the NEC.
Thank you so much. We prepare for our second race on this opening afternoon of Crufts, and it is Moulton Magnets from Northamptonshire on the far side, the red. They will have a practice run as well before each team allowed a practice run on this opening day of Cross, up against Southern Striders near Hailsham in East Sussex. Southern Striders on the near side in the blue. Bailey, Nessie, Secret and Taffy, the dogs are for Southern Striders. Formed only 4 years ago, and all the founding members of the teams are here today. Very much the underdogs, and the Striders saying they're flying the non-whippet, flying the flag for the non-whippet breeds. Proud to showcase a range of breeds. Working Cocker Spaniel, Labrador, Border Collies, to show the UK any breed of dog can play fly ball. That is the Southern Striders on the blue near side. Southern Striders near side, best of three again. Moulton Magnets from Northamptonshire on the far side in the red. The Magnets, the longest running team in Northamptonshire, established back in 2004. Team's first time back at Crufts for some time, and first time attending for most of the team as well. On the far side, Moulton Magnets, Northamptonshire. Far side, the red. Southern Striders on the near side, that is the blue. The Magnets against the Striders. Tension on the faces. All ages here. Jenny Knight. Very calm, controlled presence in the middle there. Far side, the Magnets. Near side, the Striders. We are ready to go. Bailey, Nessie, Secret and Taffy for the Striders. Inca, Jackson, Fletcher and Dexon. There's a fault on that far side. A fault on the far side then for the Magnets. So that. And another fault on the far side. So this is looking good for the Striders on the near, who only have to complete clean now. And they will have their noses in front, I would imagine. Just looking for confirmation. Indeed, it comes from Jenny Knight, who points our way. And the Striders are 1-2 the good.
just a couple of mistakes there, cost them the run, but hopefully it's best of three, so they've got every chance now to come back.
The Striders, one up then on the near side. Moulton Magnets from Northamptonshire will be out if they lose this one. It's cruel, it's quick, it's unforgiving.
Boxes. Box judges.
Are we all ready? Are the box judges ready? Is everybody ready to go? Second heat. And if you don't succeed, you don't hang around at Crofts. You're on the way home very, very quickly. The Striders are 1-2, the good on the near side. Striders, though, trailing at the moment. It's looking good for the Magnets to square things up here on the far side if they keep it tidy and if they keep it clean. Still with the Magnets on the far side. It's now down to Dexter, the last dog of the Magnets, to take it home and square things up and give us a decider. Great excite. Oh! Was that a drop ball there? Was that a drop ball there? No, it's fine. One all dropped it, presumably, after passing the line, Graham.
It did, so there was no fault. The dog carried the ball back over the finish line, which is all it's required to do. If it drops it after that, it's nothing but a distraction to the next dog running.
There we go. Well spotted, Graham. That's why you're here. Well done. One apiece, the Striders and the Magnets. East Sussex against Northamptonshire. The Magnets on the far side in the red, the Striders in the blue in the near. This to go through. Winners progress. Luders, adios. Far side, the Magnets. Near side, the Striders. Bailey, Nessie, Secret and Taffy for the Striders. Not much in it at the moment. The Striders trailing. Looking good for that second dog on the far side for Jackson. Looking good for the Magnets on that far side. And this looks though as though the Magnets from Northamptonshire are going to go through if they keep it clean and tidy in the end. It looks like a win for the far side. Celebrations on the far side. The Magnets go through on that far side. First time back across for many years. And they're not going home yet, Graham.
Well, the Magnets got their act together there. Two legs in a row. Absolutely fantastic. What I do love about this sport is that, as you can see there, we've got a, looks like a working Cocker Spaniel, but it's a sport for all dogs. Purebred, mongrels, crossbreeds, call them what you want, but it's something everybody can have a go at. We may not all be able to go at this level, but it's something everyone can have a go.
Thank you, Radzi. The action continues. All for one on the far side in the red from Bexhill and East Sussex and Commandos. Runners up here last time. The team that came second in 2020 from Stockton-on-Tees there on the near side in the blue. They will have a practice run before the real thing starts. All for one from Bexhill and East Sussex, a flyball club for 10 years, first time across age range in the team from 18 to 74. And during the pandemic, they had weekly Zoom exercise classes for the dogs and quizzes for the humans to maintain team spirit. That is all for one from Bexhill in East Sussex. Commandos, though we have seen them before, and they are a very, very accomplished outfit from Stockton-on-Tees, County Durham and Driffield. Luca, Carew, Mabel and Kaylee. Three border collies to start with for the Commandos. While all for one go Millie, Artful, Dodger, Pippin and Candy. Crossbreeds and border collie working sheepdogs. So it is the highly fancied commandos on the near side, the blue side, on the far side, the red, all for one. Bexhill in East Sussex. Can't wait to get going. First of three. Commandos, near side in the blue, all for one, far side in the red. Bit of tension around. Jenny Knight is happy. And we are away. All for one on that far side, making a good start. Just have it at the moment, but Commandos now ahead with Carew on that very quick second there. Commandos still have it on that near side with Mabel very close though. And there's a fault on the far side as well. So this will go Commandos' way on the near side in the blue. Yup, confirmation emphatically from Jenny Knight. Commandos, as anticipated, are 1-2 the good. And it means that all for one coming here to Crufts for the first time have one more race to save themselves. And it's a bit of a trip down back to Bexhill in East Sussex. They have to turn it round. All for one on the far side. The red. Commandos near side. The blue.
Boxes. Box judges. Ready on the line.
Jenny, the fly ball judge, is satisfied. We are ready. Can all 4-1 on that far side in the red pull it down? It's with Commandos at the moment. A very quick run from Luca, the opening dog. Still with Commandos and Carew. Only just though. The Artful Dodger battling back on that far side. It's very, very close. And the far side have it at the moment. That's a fine third leg that from Pippa. And now Candy. And I think they're going to square it up, aren't they? I think they've squared it up on that far side. All for one. Well done. Must admit, I thought there might be a 2-0 in the offing there, but all for one from Bexhill in East Sussex have squared it up. Millie, Artful Dodger, Pippin and Candy, and now we have another decider. Great racing. And a much higher standard this than last time a couple of years ago. One apiece. All for one. And Commandos. Commandos, a reminder, on the near side in the blue. All for one, far side in the red. Commandos, runners-up 2 years ago. Are they going to go out on the Thursday? That's the question the big crowd here in the main arena at the NEC are asking. This will be a magnificent achievement, all for one on the far side, if they pull it off. We are ready to go. All for one, far side. Good start on the near side by Commandos. Excellent start and turn. It's with Commandos at the moment. Still with Commandos on the near side. Very close though now, but Commandos only just on the near side in the blue. But as they inched away on the far side, last stop now. There's a fault on the near side. There's a fault on the near side as well. And they're running the... And the fault on the far side too. So this one is going to take a little bit of sorting out. A fault on both sides. I'm looking at Jenny Knight and she points to the near side, she points to the Commandos. Well, the form team has come through, but with a real scare there. Commandos going through 2-1. What a fine effort by all for one. That's what I meant when I said the arena is full. Close racing, Graham.
That's why we love commentating on flyball. You need eyes in the back of your head to keep an eye on everything that's going on here. So I think that Commandos will count themselves just a little bit fortunate to get away with that, but great flyball racing, and that's what makes this such a great sport. You just never know what's going to happen. Don't blink or you miss it.
So this is going to be one heck of a finale, ladies and gentlemen. We will do our practice run. And then we will be underway. 1 place left in the flyball semi-finals 2022 here at Crufts. And this is what it's all about. The excitement and energy of flyball. from Sydney, an international team competing for the very first time.
British team to reach Crofts, reigning European champions and the Belgian champions, Road Runners Beep Beep from Zonhoven in Belgium. And on the near side in the blue, this is the practice run, just to remind you, Commandos, a second entry from the Commandos Club, Commandos Allied Forces, a group of Crofts debutants in this particular team. But we are looking at the Belgians on that far side, Sepp, Tantrum, Vito and Marley, the runners, Whippet, Border Whippet Lurcher and a Malinois and Border Crossfer for the Belgians. Great to see them here. And Hyphen, Dexter, Nagini and Severus for Commandos Allied Forces, Belgian Malinois and three crossbreeds in there. And you're not missing anything, they are just warming up. This is the last of the quarterfinals on Thursday. And goodness me, what quality we have seen so far. And real huge interest in the Belgian team that have come here. Only established in 2014 in Zonhoven, reigning European champions, Belgian flyball champions last year. And they qualified in January and qualified very impressively as well. How good will they be? Will they even threaten that 15-20 Crofts record? Far side in the reds then are the Roadrunners, near side the Commandos in the blue. Best of three. First off, the Roadrunners on the far side. Commandos, what a good club they are. Second entry. And they will do very well to upset the odds here, will the Commandos. And they're running. Quick start on that far side by Sepp the Whippet. There's a false start, in fact, on that far side. So it was too fast, so really that could set back the Commandos. Set back the Roadrunners from Belgium on that far side. We look for confirmation, and indeed it comes. The Commandos have taken the opening heat. The near side wins it, and that is a surprise, and they got away. I said a quick start. It was too quick.
It was, and that won't happen again, you can say that, but that's where they can make up their time and win these events, is making sure that their start is right on the light. But let's just see what happens now, Jim.
So, under the cosh from the off then, the first non-British team to reach across, those Roadrunners, Beep Beep, from Zonhoven in Belgium, are one down and have to win here, otherwise the return trip beckons. Real tension among their faces. Jenny is set, we're all set, and the dogs are running. Good start on this near side by Commandos as well. But they have it up. Sepp just has it on the far. Now Tantrum on the far, making a bit of ground up for the Belgian. The Belgians have this one in their pocket, providing they keep it clean. Big turn from Marley, the Malinois on board across. Through they go, and that is going to be one apiece. And yet again we have a decider. Well, I did say right at the start, the people are expecting the best flyball competition for years. Phenomenal standard. We have seen that already on the first Thursday. Great, great racing here at Crofts. One apiece, Roadrunners Beep Beep and Commandos Allied Forces. This is the decider. So Commandos, really an untried team of Crofts debutants, taking on the reigning European champions and the Belgian champions as well. And could they even knock them out?
Boxes.
Could they? We're about to find out in the next few seconds. Great start to the five ball competition here at Crufts. Commandos near side. Roadrunners on the far. Who's going to start best? It's those Roadrunners who have their noses in front. Still with the Roadrunners, the Belgians on the far side. Showing their class and speed and skill. Third dog going well, and on the far side is Vito. And it looks like the European champions are going to go through here. Yes, they are indeed, with Marley, the Malinois, on board across. Yep, confirmation. Great to have them here, but they were given a real surprise. And they, well, the celebrations of relief, really. But they have gone through, and the Commando second team are out. Of course, one of the teams from that club remain. But high tension and high speed racing as well. And great to hear, to have them here, the first ever non-British team to reach Crufts. And the style and speed and grace of those dogs, I could say now on the first Thursday that they will take some beating.
Yep, BB, bit of a scare there, but they're safely through. Looking forward to seeing them in the next round.
So just confirming then, qualifying for the semi-finals on Saturday, High Flyers, Molten Magnets, Commandos, and the Belgians, Road Runners, beep, beep. Great start to fly. So here we are about to decide Thursday's champions. It is Molten Magnets from Northamptonshire on the far side, and on the near, High Flyers in the blue. The High Flyers, Orson Edge, Cubitt and Potter, Inca, Jackson, Fletcher and Dexter for Molten Magnets.
Ready on the
from nearby
boxes.
Northamptonshire.
Box judges, ready on the line.
On the far side. No practice runs now. Best of three. We're just looking to decide who is going to have the glory, if you like, of Thursday's champions. High Flyers on the near side, second best at the moment, and veering off course as well. So that's a big fall on the near side, and it is it's a double, really, for Molten Magnets on the far, providing they just keep it clean and tidy. Veered right off course, and that'll be Molten Magnets on the far side, beyond any doubt. And Jenny just waiting for things to settle down on this near side before we get confirmation of the verdict. Just complete the heat.
I cringe when I hear you say it's a doddle, because we've seen already that anything can happen here, but I know exactly what you meant. All they had to do was put four dog clear round, but who knows, it could go the other way in the next one.
It could indeed. I will lose the word doddle from my vocabulary.
Oh, only when it comes to flyball, Jim.
Don't want you cringing. Molten Magnets then one to the good after early mistake from the High Flyers. I think that's awesome, the opening dog for the High Flyers. Pretty much taking the wrong course. So the High Flyers have this one to pull it round if they want to be named as Thursday's champions. Molten Magnets.
Boxes!
On the far.
Box judges. Are you on the line?
Far side, the red side. Near side is the blue. High Flyers on the blue side. and the magnets on the far in the red. And we are away, and again it looks like it's with the far side and the magnets, but only just. The magnets have a little bit of daylight. The magnets opening things up. There might be a fault on that far side, I think I'm hearing. Still with them. Still with them at the moment, but I'm hearing there's a fault on the far side. So it comes to the near, and the High Flyers have squared it up because of a fault on that far side by the magnets.
And it was a crossover fault. You can clearly see they've got to pass nose to nose, but the incoming dog can't be on the course before the outgoing dog has got his nose through the gates.
Well done, Graham. One apiece then. Again, we have a decider to reach the final this afternoon and decide Thursday's champions. One apiece, the magnets and the flyers.
Boxes! Box judges!
Magnets in the red on the far. I really like Jenny Knight's style controlling this frantic event. Flyers on the near, magnets are far. Not much in it at the moment, just with the flyers on the near side. Still with the flyers. This is good from the flyers on the near side. They still have it, and this is a really quick third dog for the flyers. It's for the flyers to lose now if they keep it clean. Quick turn on the near side. This has gone the flyers' way. The flyers surely have got this. Yes, they have indeed. That was really good after a shaking start by the flyers. They pulled things right round, and they have gone through, and they're in with a chance of being Thursday's champions, Graham.
Thursday flyers, well, they've managed to get their acts together. And I say, these rounds are all about bragging rights. What they want to do is they want to win today's competition to say to the other teams, if you think you're good enough, bring it on for the semi-finals.
Absolutely.
Great flyball racing, great entertainment. And the crowd in the arena here are just going absolutely mad. They're loving it.
And absolutely, of course, valuable extra running time as well. Really, really helps everybody. Dogs, handlers, everyone. Okay, this could be a very, very special race, this. The Commandos, runners-up last time, against the overseas competitors, the Roadrunners Beep Beep from Belgium. This could be really high quality, and you never know, this might just be a rehearsal for Sunday's final. You never, never know. Could be. The Belgians are on the far side, the red, and Commandos from Stockton-on-Tees in the near, in the blue. Hugely impressive, the Commandos. Before things were ceased last year, they were runners-up in 2020. With the reigning European champions and the Belgian champions as well, are a wonderfully accomplished team. They're in the far side. Commandos are near. Best of three. And we're racing. Very good start by the dog on the far side. The Belgians have it at the moment, the Roadrunners. Still with the Roadrunners on the far side. Clear daylight between them and the Commandos on the near. Ooh, but there's a fault on the far side again. Same thing has happened in the real competition. Probably went off too quickly, and a little slip on the far side. And a fault on the near side as well. So faults on both sides. And another fault on the far side. We're going to look to Jenny Knight very closely on this and see which way she is going to go. I'm suggesting it'll be the Commandos. I'm not 100% certain. We will get confirmation at the moment. Still running some dogs on that far side. Don't talk about road runners, it's dog runners. And they get it. Okay, the road runners get it on the far side. I would love to be able to tell you exactly why, but I'm afraid it's beyond me, Graham, that one.
I was going to say the same thing. If you were going to turn to me, Jim, and said, explain what happened there.
Would I throw you under that particular fly ball bus? I'd never do that to you. The reigning European champions, Belgian record holders on the far side, are 1-2 the good after a chaotic opening race sorted out by Jenny Knight, our flyball judge. Gave it to the Belgian commandos. Certainly have the ability to strike back here, but will they? All racing for bragging rights to be called Thursday's champion. Good start on the far side again. It's with the Belgians once more. Commandos with ground to make up. Ground opening up. Goodness me, they have some quick dogs in that team, do the Belgians. There's a vast amount of space between them and this. If they keep it clean and keep it tidy, they are going to go. They're going to go through. There's also a fault on the near side. This will go the Belgians' way. This, they're celebrating already, and we just need that little confirmation, and we get it. It's gone with the Belgians on the far side. They go through, and just for the right to be called Thursday's champions, they might be Sunday's champions as well. You never know, Greg.
So good flyball racing, and I think the Belgian team are actually still settling down and absorbing the atmosphere of this fantastic arena and almost the 7,000 people that there are here. So I don't actually think we've seen the best of the Belgians yet, but all I can say is, who would be a flyball judge? I think I'm far happier being an agility judge, far easier.
Right, before the grand final, we are going to do the third, fourth place playoffs, ladies and gentlemen, because we just love flyball. Let's welcome the commandos! And then we're going to come back against someone.
So we're just about to have the runoffs for third and fourth, and they're just sorting out who's going to be on which side.
Yep, I think it's going to be the Magnets from nearby Northamptonshire on the far side. That is the red side. Longest running team in Northampton, established, 18 years ago. Haven't been here at Crufts for a while, but are doing really well. So, first time for many of the participants at Crufts. And on the near side, the blue, are the Commandos. By the way, the first dog, Luca, the Border Collie, that was rescued at the 11th hour. He's going to be put to sleep, but he's now a reformed character due to all the hard work put in by his owners. That's a great story. That came second in 2020. And now looking to go one better in 2022. Of course, no fly ball, no Crufts last year. And it's welcome back, Crufts, and hello again, fly ball. We know why we love you. Magnets from Northamptonshire on the far side. The Commandos from Stockton-on-Tees, from Durham and Driffield are on the near. Best of three, this to find out who's going to be third and who's going to be fourth.
Box judges, it's on the line.
The Commandos on the near hill, just in front. Good opening leg by that dog. Still with the Commandos on the near side on the blue, but only just. They're making up ground on the far. There's very little in it now. The Magnets in the far still with a bit to do, but have they got it just at the moment? Is it with the Magnets? No, not quite. Commandos near side. Is there a fault out there? And there is a fault on the near side, and it's gone. It's gone with the far. It's gone with the Magnets on that far side because of a fault on the opening leg, Graham.
Yes, it was a fault on the near side. And unfortunately, he dropped the ball before he came back through the gates, which was a fault, and they decided not to rerun that dog.
Well, the Magnets one up. Who's going to be third? Who's going to be fourth? If the Commandos on the near side do not pull this one round, they will be fourth, and Molten Magnets will be third on Thursday in a very satisfying day's work. That will be indeed for the Magnets. Good start as well on that far side, but eating up ground on the near. It's with the Commandos at the moment. And the near side in the blue. Still just with the Commandos. It could well be a fault on the near side, though, by the Commandos as well. So they're leading they're finishing first, but they could well be finishing fourth as well because of a fault on this near side. The judge might well point to the far, and it could be the Magnets. Yep, well done those Magnets. They've come third. The Commandos have come fourth, and the Commandos will want to tidy things up for the rest of Crofts. But that's a really fine achievement by Moulton Magnets from Northamptonshire. First time back at Crofts for some time, in the top three on the Thursday.
Yeah, and unfortunately the dog dropped the ball again, but good steady fly ball racing there from Moulton, and a well-deserved win for them.
So now we're going to find out who will be Thursday's champions. Will it be the High Flyers, drawn from Lincolnshire, Bedfordshire and Northamptonshire? Multiple times UK record holders, current European multi-breed record holders as well. And up against our overseas friends from Belgium, the Roadrunners Beep Beep, who have set all sorts of records. Qualified here in January, reigning European champions, the Belgian champions, and with lots of whippets in there, and lurchers and Malinar crossing, really, really fast dogs. They are on the far side.
So you can see now pictures of the teams just actually showing the dogs the box and the fly ball box loaders, and it's just so that they start to get them just a little bit wound up and say that's where you're going to go and get that ball.
It's the High Flyers then to decide the Thursday's champions. In the blue, on the near side, against Beep Beep Roadrunners from Belgium. First overseas team here. Will they be the Thursday champions? And indeed, will they go all the way? They've been mightily impressive so far. What a flying start from the Belgians on that far side. Oh, that is unbelievably quick start. Lightning second dog as well. This is going all the way. If they keep it clean, there's a fault on the near side with the High Flyers as well. This will go beep, 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 beep. This is going to go the Belgians' way. Yep. One to the good. The Belgians, surely, as they're in their quest to become Thursday's champions.
And that's what Beep Beep are doing. They're putting pressure on the other team, and they're forcing mistakes out of them. It's looking good for them so far.
Well, they're not messing around, that is for sure. So had my card marked talking to people about this competition, they would be the team to beat. They've shown that so far. Another win here and they will be Thursday's champions. That is Roadrunners from Zonhoven in Belgium, giving all their dogs an outing here as well. Climax of Thursday's competition. We're deciding Thursday's champions. You'll be a brave man to bet against the Belgians. They have it just at the moment on that far side, increasing their lead with the second dog on the far side, and the third going so well. Barring something, misfortune, they're going to take it. Is there a fault on the far side? It all looks pretty clean. They're celebrating. There's fists in the air from Beep Beep Roadrunners. Confirmation, 2-0 to the Roadrunners. The Roadrunners from Belgium are Thursday's champions. And they have very much already, although we haven't seen all the teams here, established themselves as the team to beat.
Some very happy, happy people there from Belgium. You can see why their reputation goes before them from competing in Belgium. And the start, I mean, I haven't got the figures there, but they must be close on to a tenth or even less than that on the changeover.
It's called a flying start, Grant.
Thank you.
The Roadrunners Beep Beep, our overseas visitors to Crofts, our Thursday's champions. No.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the presentation. Please welcome back the winners of the flyball quarterfinals, all the way from Belgium, the first non-UK team to compete here at Crufts. Roadrunners, beep beep!
And here we are with the...
To do our presentation, we welcome from Royal Canin, Martin Cherry, and Stuart Payne from the Kennel Beep Beep
from Belgium, the first ever overseas team that we've had here competing at Crufts. So very, very well deserved. And they've laid down the mantle, if you like, and they've got said to all the other teams...
And our runners-up, what a performance that was. They battled into the end. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the High Flyers!
And then the High Flyers... did really, really well. Have we seen the best of them? We'll have to wait till Saturday to see. But it really, really good team.
Okay, let's have a quick chat with the captain of our winning team here. This was well worth the journey, wasn't it? What does it mean to you, not only to be winning this, to be going forward to the semi-finals, but also to be setting a new Crufts record for flyball?
We are a fan for so many years, watching Crufts flyball. With the whippets, I got my own whippets because of Crufts flyball, and now we stand here, so I have no words.
And give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Wasn't that fantastic? So, is it going to be the same again when you get into the semis? Are you going to have different tactics? How's it going to play out at the weekend?
I think we're going to have some beers and then some thinking, because some dogs were reacting quite strange. The environment is quite difficult for the dogs.
Fantastic stuff, ladies and gentlemen. What an amazing team. What a performance. Let's hear it for the Roadrunners!